This is the moment I ruined Johnny Carey's career. In this contract, he signed his life over to me, but at this moment, he didn't know it yet. See, I made him believe he was joining a company called Brooklyn Tidal. I got him to sign a contract and speak about it on a live radio show. But this was all from the last video. We continue from where we left off. Johnny and I had separated, and I felt awful.
Johnny, I'm so sorry, because we're not even finished.
See, this all happened on the 26th of July, but over the next days, Johnny did the following. Put Brooklyn Tidal in his social media descriptions, uploaded a sponsored video to his YouTube channel.
Why is the TV off? Because, Dad, there's this new platform called Brooklyn Tidal. It lets you watch a mix of TV, YouTube, alongside pranks, vlogs, skits, and a lot more, all in one hub.
He also pushed his subscribers to comment, because whoever got the most people to say Brooklyn Tidal out of me and him would get a 5k bonus.
Every person in the comments that puts Brooklyn Tidal in the comments is Brooklyn Tidal, and I go through and like everyone. And also, if you don't, then you know, you're gonna get 5 years of bad luck.
He got 6,000 comments, and shout out to Johnny, because even though he knew he'd win our little competition, he said he'd split the 5k bonus with me, which was really generous. It's just a shame it wasn't real.
We've just watched the integration from Johnny. What are your thoughts? He went for it, he went all out.
You can see in his face, he genuinely thinks he's getting 25k.
I feel bad.
But that wasn't it. He got the Brooklyn Tidal YouTube channel to 991 subscribers, where I uploaded the most epic hype trailer. Genuinely the best thing you will ever see.
That was like a joke video. That was like the fucking music was like a war film. This is what, they've made our voice deeper. Like, whoever edited it, it was a fucking shit editor. No wonder he left college.
I mean, I was gonna reveal the prank to him, but after hearing him insult my editing, I needed a holiday to recover, so I delayed it all by a week to enjoy myself. I'm currently in France right now, and I can't stop thinking about this prank. I just really don't know how I'm gonna tell him. It's too late to turn back now, and all the break did was hype Johnny up even more.
I'm not even gonna lie though, I am actually excited to be a part of it. I am surprised in a way, because there's such a fucking big company as Virgin Media.
I'm gonna get 5,000 fucking pounds, yeah? 5k for comments on a video on an internet website. Fucking comments.
After a few days in France, I flew back to England as I had a few things I had to clear up. See, in our contracts, Johnny needed to upload on Sunday the 29th of July, and I needed to upload on Wednesday the 1st of August. But suiting to my character, I missed my upload day, meaning Johnny's imaginary payment got delayed. And as you can imagine, he wasn't happy. Alright, so we were just chilling here, eating a Chinese, got Sharky right over there. Johnny has just sent me a ton of messages. Two missed phone calls, and these are some of the messages he sent me.
Mr. Upload, man, why didn't you upload today? This is nearly 30k we're talking about each. How can you want to delay anymore, man? I want to pay off stuff and that.
Oh no, this got deep. No, that's
Wait,
not why I
want
to hear. The reason I was so scared is because I was worried Johnny had already put a payment down for his Mercedes. See, since the beginning of this prank, Johnny's had his mind set on a Mercedes A-Class 180. This is a car that costs £20,000. So if Johnny puts a payment down, this would mean it's not just a prank anymore.
It's pure evil.
Yeah, no, exactly. So I needed Johnny to call me to make sure he hadn't done anything rash. And he wanted to make sure I was getting my imaginary video out ASAP. Oh, here we go. Okay, so Johnny's calling me again. Let's answer.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, you need the money, man, because you can't fuck up broadcasting it.
Do you need the money now?
Well, it's not a need, I want to.
There we go! Johnny hadn't done anything rash, but that doesn't mean he wasn't planning to.
It's not a big deal, but it's kind of annoying. I was going to go find a Mercedes and stuff.
You're literally going to buy the Mercedes like that?
Yeah, why?
Oh, you're not wasting time. The fear we all had at this moment was unbelievable, but Johnny just wanted to make sure I wasn't going to mess up this deal.
Can you email them now, please? Email them.
Okay, I'll email them. He was going on about how I messed up and I needed to email them so much that I convinced myself this whole thing was real and started defending my case. It's not gonna... We signed the contract, Johnny. They took us... There's no way this isn't, like, happening.
Yeah, but they wouldn't say an email.
I snapped back into it and realised how out of order what I just said was. But I wouldn't do it again because I'd learned my lesson. Okay, you can trust me, man. I have never, ever learnt my lesson. You guys should know this by now. But alright. Okay, I'll send the email. I'll send it. BrooklynTidal@gmail.com. Alright, bye, man. Okay, we're terrible people. No. Okay.
Oh my god.
We have done a terrible thing.
No.
I have done a terrible thing. Okay, I take responsibility. I think the only thing I can do, honestly, the only thing that will make him actually like me is if I buy him a Mercedes.
And how the hell are you gonna do that?
This is a crime. I'm sure if Johnny wanted to sue me, he could sue me.
Say that on camera. I
just don't know what to do. My Chinese has got cold.
I don't know, man. It's just turned into the worst thing ever.
Okay, I can't do this anymore, man. I can't do this anymore. Turn it off. One thing was for sure, I needed to finish this prank as soon as possible. I couldn't do Friday because Chunks pulled out. I couldn't do Saturday because Johnny was at a festival. I couldn't do Sunday because Chunks pulled out again. To keep Johnny calm, I literally faked an email from Brooklyn Tidal saying everything was going to be okay. But then we reached Monday. And Monday was filming day. And today's the day I tell Johnny it was all a prank. Hopefully I don't lose a friend today. I need to do it the right way. And then I've got a couple surprises for him as well.
I am nervous for you, mate.
I feel like one of those idiot pranksters who took things like way too far.
I mean, you are crushing his dreams in a way, because what was it he wanted again? What was it he wanted?
He wanted a Mercedes. Now I have to do this reveal right. So let me talk you through my plan. The reveal was going to be taking place on the TV in the office of Chunks' house. I'd have Sharky there ready on the sofa to reveal it all because Chunks didn't want anything to do with it.
But I'm not getting involved.
I put the 30-second reveal in a 9-minute video so Johnny would think it was going to be a normal upload. We had two cameras set up for filming it, one on a tripod and one which George would secretly be sat in the corner filming on. I went on Amazon and bought a toy Mercedes so that once the prank reveal had been played, I could then enter the room with Johnny's dream car. So now that's all explained, Johnny had arrived and the prank was ready to be revealed. First thing I did was set up the cameras and we already had a setback.
Turn the camera off while you're waiting.
So we were one camera down and we just had to get on with it.
It's about the 30k now.
I've got most of it done.
It's on Friday, yeah? So I will not be driving that Corsa anymore.
Oh, you're going for next.
I'm going the next day, I'm going to the car drive.
Johnny talking about buying the Mercedes was all too much for Chunks, so we walked out and Sharky knew exactly why. I then told Sharky to put the video on. And it was time for the big reveal, what we've all been waiting for.
Nah, Minister, you should make it time.
Yeah, no, but it's missing the intro, the car bit. Me and my friend Johnny are part of a thing called Brooklyn Tidal. Now, Brooklyn Tidal is a combination between YouTube and TV. I have a feeling you guys are going to like it a lot. Trust me, guys, I'm thinking this is going to be the next big thing. Hi there, Johnny. Stay seated, because trust me, I think you're going to want to listen to this whole thing. Over the last few weeks, we've been in talk with Virgin over a life-changing brand deal. Well, it's all made up, Johnny. Ian and Catherine and I have been in on everything. All of it was planned to perfection. The Brooklyn Tidal t-shirts, well, I printed them myself. The contract you signed, fake. Even the radio show we appeared on together live is fake. We lied to you on live radio just to prank you. The whole time, you were talking to me. How does it feel to be trolled by Nico? This'll teach you for taking 50k FIFA coins off me 4 years ago. Oh, and one last thing. I know this is a little far, Johnny. I know you said you were gonna get a Mercedes, so I bought you a little gift. Oh, I think I see it coming in now. Oh, what a nice car that is. Would you look at that Mercedes?
Wait, is that
Oh, Johnny. It was all worth it.
It's
oh, what a lovely Mercedes. Pick it up. Pick it up, Johnny. Kiss it.
No, I don't believe you.
Kiss the Mercedes.
I don't believe you.
Kiss it, Johnny.
I can't do this. Is he filming?
Cheeky 25k, man.
I don't believe you.
Nah.
I don't believe you.
Johnny pointed out there was still 9 minutes left on the video, but the final 9 minutes was literally me saying cheeky 25k Merc on loop, so I had to turn it off. Pick it up, Johnny, and kiss it. Oh, listen, it's a prank. It's, I'll be honest with you, it's a prank. But,
But the whole thing?
The whole thing was a prank.
How have you set it up then?
Well, how did I set it up?
That's a piss take.
What do you mean?
That's taking, oh, you're
a I've got you another deal. Now, I'll be honest, I wasn't expecting Johnny to react this way. I didn't even think he'd be upset. I honestly thought he'd laugh. I'm just a very, very stupid guy. I tried telling him I sorted him out another brand deal, which I set up when I was planning the prank, but he wasn't interested.
I don't care.
Shocky and I were then trying to explain the prank to Johnny by his car. Meanwhile, George was literally filming himself shaking. He's shaking because he filmed the prank. George, relax, it's not a war zone. Then Johnny drove off. He didn't want to hear anything Shocky or I had to say. And that was the last time I saw him.
How you feeling?
Nice, cute, man.
That's literally to the T, almost. That's what I thought would happen.
Johnny's reaction was not what I was expecting, and I tried explaining my mindset to him. I never, and I guess this is arguably the worst part, but I never saw it as like deeper than a YouTube prank, and all I can do is apologize for that, and I do feel bad. After a month, no progress was made. It got so desperate, I made an apology video for Johnny.
I miss you so bad. I don't forget you.
This didn't work either. I got to the point where I was emailing brands left, right, and center to actually buy him the Mercedes. But guess what? Johnny ended up buying the car anyways. Johnny's bought the new car, and that's what I wanted to do. And now I'm lost. Now I'm really lost. I'm stressed, man. I wanted to buy him the car. There was no way of resolving things because Johnny genuinely thought I was trying to ruin his career with the prank, and he didn't even want to watch the original video, so I couldn't prove him wrong. It was basically game over. Until Friday the 28th of September, when Johnny finally started to come round.
Here's what I'm going to say, Nico, yeah? If the video is genuinely just made out to be a joke, like I know you're saying it is, but if it's genuinely made out to be a joke, then I could probably start resolving it with you. I'm being serious.
So I sent Johnny the video, and his response was a massive relief.
I feel like crying. I honestly feel like crying. This is what I wanted from the start.
I've been trying to sort this situation out for 2 months and now it's finally over. It's driven me crazy, I'm not gonna lie, I've gone mad. But all I had to do was send him the vid. So now it's time to see Johnny for the first time in 2 months.
I'm filming.
Okay, so we're going to meet Johnny for the first time. I think this is him here. First meeting, right? He's got his new car. Oh my god.
Long time.
Very long time, my friend. Very long time. Oh, okay. So for the Nando's, yeah?
Buy me a meal to make up for it.
Johnny said he'd meet me on one condition. If I bought him a Nando's, then I thought it was a fair deal.
I'm just gonna have a small meal.
Especially because he said it would only be small.
I have no bones fat, please. Extra hot. 2 fried chips, slice of rice, and a
small
cob.
4
paranades.
Oh! 4
paranades! And a drink, please. Also, can I get some olives as well?
I could literally hear my bank account screaming. I'm not joking, but I had to firm it for the cameras.
Look at that. See? George just took. No, they're not your olives. Look, listen, as long as they're paper on my side, they're mine. Do you want olives, George?
Yeah, go on.
See?
Go on.
Yeah? The cameraman's allowed one, you're not.
Now I understand I deserve this. Me and Johnny spoke about this situation and I still had one more surprise for him.
I got people who have a message for you as well. Ian.
Ian and Catherine wanted to give one final message to Johnny.
Johnny, I'm so sorry.
I feel terrible, man. I've not been able to sleep. I'm really sorry. I'm really sorry.
That's the fakest, not been able to sleep. That's man. I'm sorry, Ian, I tried.
I then wanted to hear Johnny's views on the whole prank from his perspective.
This prank was over, what, 3 weeks?
Yeah.
Kind of that. And you know, after we left the Virgin Media thing, I was thinking in my head, Virgin Media, that's a big company, yeah? It's a lot of money. Who wouldn't get gas for that amount of money, do you know what I mean?
And then I went and told my family, my friends. Yeah, we went on radio. I was thinking, so, like, do you know what I mean? If you was in my situation, you would have done the same thing. But yeah, nah. It's all good. It's squashed now.
Squashed.
Yeah, it is.
There we go.
So there we go. A happy ending. Make sure you subscribe to Johnny Carey and comment on every single one of his videos for the rest of time. The NDL send our regards. The NDL are strong people. We just pulled off the greatest prank of all time. And these are my final thoughts. Okay, I just want to round this up with, I'm glad we've been able to get a happy ending. Massive shout out to Johnny Carey. Just make sure you subscribe to him. It feels weird putting it out though, because I've literally been sat on this for 2 months. It feels like my baby at this point. But yeah, like the video, because I do feel like I've aged like 5 years. I'll see you guys very soon. Goodbye. And now I die.